of you that don't know is many years ago I used to have a few colonies of bees myself. In actual fact, my brother Robert and myself, we had 40 colonies, and we were about to join the Bee Farmers Association, and then nature took its course and I ended up getting married. And my brother Robert didn't like getting stung, and he developed an allergy, and he had to pack it up. So in the end I gave up the beekeeping, but I've still got a bit of knowledge. Although I've not been in a hive now for a few years, it'd be interesting to go in. And Aunt wants me to break the hive down, we'll put the supers down behind me here, and then what do you want me to do, search for queen cells?
No, the hive been re-queened recently. Yeah. So I snail groved the hive.
Yeah.
So we moved the snail grove board last week.
Yeah.
So as you can see now, you can see the newspaper sticking out.
Yeah. Now what snail groving is, it's where you unite two colonies. If you just unite them one on top of the other, there's a good chance there'll be a big warfare, it'll cause a war amongst the bees. But by putting newspaper in between, then the bees have got to chew away at the newspaper, and then they get to meet each other gradually, and hopefully then you manage to unite two colonies and form one strong hive. Yeah, go on, Ant.
Yeah, so literally the more grey brood chamber, the plastic piece on the back.
Yeah.
As of last weekend, that was at the very top.
Right.
With the snail grove board between it.
Yeah.
So last week, snail grove board was removed. Newspaper was placed above the first brood chamber.
Yeah.
Second brood chamber about placed on top. You see the queen excluder, the thin wooden gap above the brood chamber.
Yeah.
And there's three supers on there. So at the moment, that super you're touching now, Sandy, is pretty naked.
Yeah.
The two above it are practically full already.
Well, are they capped over, do you think?
You'll have a nose when you're in there, but they're looking really, really good.
Yeah.
So literally the task of the day, Sandy, is take the roof off, put the supers, as I said, behind you.
Yeah.
Take the grey brood chamber off, stack that on top temporarily.
Yeah.
Remove the newspaper and just restack it all back up. And while you're in there...
In that same order.
Absolutely, back in that order. If you want to have a nose through the hive while you're in there, have a look at the supers, the condition of the honey, see if they're capped. If you want to have a glance at the brood, carry on.
Okay, let's get cracking then. Literally with the hive tool.
The only rule is don't squish the queen.
I'll try not to.
Because they've been re-queened.
Yeah, I'll try not to.
Right, I'm going to go around the other side and let you play.
Put the microphone there. I've got gloves. Nice gauntlets to put on to keep the bees from getting at my hands. It's a nice warm day, so I think they're going to be quite gentle.
They're well natured, these ones, Andy.
Yeah, they're well natured, so Aunt says.
You'll soon find out. There isn't loads in there, they're only just burning. Proof, Sandy, I often do it without a smoker anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're not badly natured at all. I'll
give them a bit of smoke. Smoker's not smoking very well. Right. You ever read a book called R.O.B. Manley? Honey Farming by R.O.B. Manley?
I have
not. Oh, it's a brilliant book. They haven't popularised it down too bad.
Well, I removed it all the other week and put it all back together, so you shouldn't be too stuck together at all, Sandy.
No.
Place it straight on top of that lid.
Now, the smell. What you can't get is the smell. I'm actually experiencing a beautiful smell and aroma of the bees. I'll try and pull out a capped honey frame.
To me, it's the smell of the bees, the honey, but also it was just the actual cedar wood smelled beautiful.
Yeah. Now this is a super frame, and you can see it's capped over, and just beneath that there is a lovely honey, just beautiful.
You can stab the tool in there and show them, Sandy, if you like.
Yeah, I just done that. So that's it. And this is the bees would normally keep this for their winter storage. So just look at that, beautiful golden honey, and it's been harvested from the allotments around about. So it's all good quality stuff. They're coming off nicely. Hans said he has been through the hive recently.
Sorry, Sandy. One thing I made sure to check. So that super there, the next one you're getting off, that was the brand new naked one.
Right. Okay.
Have they started roaring yet? It's the interesting factor.
Right now, in this super here, Ant's put new frames and foundation in, and you can see that the bees, they're beginning to think about it, but they haven't drew the foundation out. What foundation is, basically, it's a wax beeswax sheet with impressed the structures of the cell, the cells that the bees would draw out, and it's got wires running through it to reinforce it. So they haven't started drawing it out yet. Got that one open. Still quite light. Plenty of room in there. Now
in a busy area.
Now this here, this is the queen excluder. Now, what the queen excluder does, it does two things. It keeps the queen down. Sorry about the buzzing in the background, noise from the vehicle. The queen can't physically fit through the gaps in the excluder. But also it keeps the drones out of the honey storage area. This is popolized down a little bit. Some of the frames are stuck to it. So you can see. Sorry, Ant, what were you saying?
Carry on, Zach.
Yeah. So we have got some drones. Some drones are through. Drones are getting through it then, by the looks of it. So this bee here, this is the fatter bee there. I can't see one now. There's one there. The fatter bee is the male bee. This one here, he's a male bee. Called the drone. They have no sting, and they generally they're only around during the summer months. The rest of the year they just die off or they're kicked out.
One rule, Sandy, when you take the queen excluder off, flip it
you're right, yeah.
Just in case the queen is on the underside.
Yeah, you're quite right.
That's the underside there, isn't it?
Ant's reminded me to check the queen excluder to make sure the queen's not on it, because we don't want to get into the supers. But of course, you know, being not a current beekeeper, I'm out of the loop a little bit. I better angle you up a little bit. I don't think you can see much. There, maybe you can see more now. Right, anyway. Let's bring the camera in for a closer look. So,
the top brood chamber, Sandy, is going to be the quieter one.
So what we got here is the top brood chamber. It was separated by the newspaper, which has been nibbled through now, and then the bottom brood chamber, and we have one huge colony of bees, and they're very placid bees, I must say. I'm not being buzzed or attacked at all. I think bees can also pick up on your own nervousness as well, like all animals can.
I believe from that perspective, Sally, I think the most pheromone related.
We
are panicky and promoting those pheromones,
and sweating and stuff like that. So anyway, I'm going to put you back on the camera now. On the tripod, mate.
Hopefully that newspaper has been nibbled through.
Yeah, I think so. Yes, it has.
Good.
Yeah. Well, this is a bit heavier now because it's a bigger, deeper chamber.
Oh, yes, they definitely have gone through that.
Oh yeah, it's completely gone. The queen generally will go to the darker area. If there's a queen in there, she'll move to the... If there's a queen in the hive, she'll generally go to this. The dark areas. Right, this is a brood frame. This is a brood frame, and what you're seeing in the middle is capped over larvae. Then the rest of the cells are filled with honey, and generally they also put pollen. They also store pollen around the outside. And oftentimes you'll see along the lower edges, especially if a double brood chamber or a brood and a half, you'll often see queen cells forming along this area here, so it's a good place to check for queen cells. But on this side you can see, I don't know if the camera's picking it up, you can see the white larvae. These larvae are soon to be capped over. I'm actually trying to look for eggs, but I haven't got my reading glasses on. But there's definitely young larvae in there. If you can't find the queen, sometimes you can find eggs. And then if the eggs are beginning to lie over, they could be sort of 2 or 3 days old. But if you find eggs that are standing up on end, then you know you've got the queen there and she's been laying very recently, perhaps that day even. So now a bit of house maintenance. Aunt wants me to just clean off all this newspaper. Just give them a bit of smoke. Smoke, when they smell smoke, what their reaction is to go and get as much honey as they can in their honey stomachs, because then they can, if they need to vacate their home through it burning down, they've got enough stored provisions to start up a new colony. I have to smoke them down so I don't kill many bees. Unfortunately, a beekeeper always squashes a few bees. Can't be helped.
Imagine the maintenance stand here, there's probably over 50,000 in there.
Yeah, possibly are.
It's not that full at the moment, but they're all out foraging, having a nice day.
So I'm just rebuilding the hive now in its reverse order. We hope that the queen remained in the brood chamber.
Yeah, fine.
This, you can't quite see it, but the bees have glued part of the hives together, and they've glued it with a substance known as propolis. It's quite a, it's bee glue, but apparently it's an aphrodisiac, isn't it? Propolis.
Well, I like you stand even not that much.
Or it's some sort of a beauty therapy as well, used for that. So anyway,
See you later. You're moving them?
No, just we go putting them back together. Re-cleaning them.
Yeah, just put the light soup back on. And put the crown board back on.
Don't look in the greenhouse.
And then lastly...
Don't look.
Why?
Don't look.
Very nice tomatoes.
Lastly, we put the lid back on. So that's the hive rebuilt. That's the hive rebuilt now. So my brother Robert and myself, we had 40 colonies. One point in the front of the hive. The entrance to the hive is just there, and you can see the buzzing bees. Let's move the microphone over so you can get it. Yeah, you can see the buzzing bees now. Listen to them buzz. Isn't that a magic sound? And there's Aunt. There he is. Look.
I'm out again with the chickens.
Yeah, so that's the bees. Mr. Rochman's gone through a beehive for you. So I think we're going to go on and have a look at Aunt's chickens now. I didn't get one bee buzz me, so in theory I could have actually gone in there without any protection at all, and I wouldn't have been stung today. But being stung by bees isn't the most pleasant of experiences. I've had loads of stings in the past, so it's always best to be protected, whatever you're doing with them. Right then, this is Aunt and his hens. This is on Aunt's allotment. He's moving soon. He's moving house, and he's moving all his bees and his hens, and he's moving his.
Oh,
is there any specific breed for that, Aunt?
She is a
cross between the leghorn and something else.
The leghorn.
So she's a leghorn. So she lays pure white eggs.
Right.
Big blondie over there with the fluffy feet. She lays pink eggs. And the darky brown one lays chocolate brown eggs.
Oh, nice.
Yes, nice collection. No eggs today, they're off laying at the moment because it's far too warm.
Yeah, don't blame them. So anyway, this is Ant's allotment and what's left of it. And he's had a nice, he's built himself a nice fire pit. Be a shame to see it go, really. A nice place to sit and relax. And there's his fire pit down there. There's his three bin compost bin. Yeah, he's really worked hard to get this established like this. So anyway, that's it from me. Where have you gone, Ant?
Looking at the bee compound.
That's it, we've done the bees, we've done the hens, we've had a look round.
Sandy.
Hello.
How about explaining why the compound's there?
Oh yeah, the compound. The bees are in the compound. Now this is to make the bees fly up and not into people, basically, and so they don't cause a nuisance. But in actual fact, in this environment, they're far from a nuisance because they're pollinating everybody's plants, and the allotment is flourishing as a result of having the bees here. So anyway, Ant, thanks for showing the Wiltshire Man your bees. There's Ant. I think Ant might be on the verge of starting his own YouTube channel up.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Come see the bees again.
You come see the bees again. Thanks for watching, everybody. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye for now.